Status Quo and The Wild Side of Life. Thanks to Paul Ramsbottom for that. And a reminder, if you have a song where you think the cover version made in the 70s beats the original, please send an email to walker@bbc.co.uk. And the same address, of course, for requests and dedications, walker@bbc.co.uk. Thanks for letting me share your Sunday afternoon. Thanks too to Steve Harris, Johnny California and Stephen Mitchell from Listen, who produce the show for Radio 2. I'll be back with The Rock Show on Friday night at 11 and more Sounds of the 70s next Sunday at 3. Coming up next, it's Rob Beckett. Johnny Walker saying take good care till the next time. Now, the latest news at 5 p.m. on BBC Radio 2.
This is Radio 2.
On BBC Sounds.
And on your smart speaker.
Play BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at 5 o'clock. This is Andrew Peach. The number of migrants who've arrived in the UK in small boats since the start of this year has fallen by almost a quarter compared with the same period in 2022. Figures compiled by the BBC show that so far 7,610 people have crossed the Channel. That's a fall of more than 2,000 on last year. The government says its plan to detain and deport anyone arriving illegally will act as a deterrent. Officials in India say their investigation into what caused the train disaster on Friday is focusing on the computer-controlled track management system, which directs a train to an empty line at the point where two tracks meet. It's suspected the system malfunctioned, causing a crash involving three trains in the state of Odisha. At least 275 people were killed. A local journalist, Subrat Kumar Patti, says many of them are yet to be identified.
Until now, only 100 diseased persons has been identified, and about 175 dead bodies are lying unidentified. So if huge number of bodies are there which has not been identified, this is a challenge, and government has accepted this.
A funeral's been held of a 12-year-old girl who died after being pulled from the sea in Bournemouth on Wednesday. Sunna Khan from High Wycombe in Buckinghamshire died in the incident involving 10 swimmers. A 17-year-old boy from Southampton, Joe Abbess, also died after he was pulled from the sea. Dorset Police is investigating the incident. A man has been arrested and released pending further investigation. A group of anti-Putin Russian paramilitaries based in Ukraine say they've crossed the border into Russia's Belgorod region and captured two Russian soldiers. The claim was made by a man identifying himself as the commander of the Russian Volunteer Corps. The governor of the Belgorod region called the group killers and fascists. In Formula One, the reigning champion Max Verstappen has extended his lead with a victory in the Spanish Grand Prix in Barcelona. Lewis Hamilton was second, with his Mercedes teammate George Russell third. Verstappen now leads the Drivers' Championship by 53 points.
It's a big pleasure, you know, to drive with a car like this. We had quite a lot of different tyre strategies out there. I think for most of the race we're on the right one, but a win here, it's incredible. And hopefully, you know, we can just keep that up throughout the year.
Real Madrid have announced their captain, Karim Benzema, is leaving the club. He joined the team from Lyon 14 years ago. And as our sports news correspondent Paul Scott explains, he's had a very successful career there.
His total of 353 club goals is bettered only by Cristiano Ronaldo. Benzema has won 4 La Liga and 5 Champions League titles. The 2023 Ballon d'Or winner has been linked with a move to Saudi Arabia.
The weather forecast: dry tonight across the UK, mild for many of us under a blanket of cloud coming from the east. BBC News, it's 5:03. Now, here's Orna with the latest Radio 2 travel news.
Andrew, thank you very much. It's been persistently busy in places today, actually. It's not been too bad overall. The A9 in Perthshire on the southbound side, the A912 at the Inverolmond roundabout. There have been queues backing up to Bankford. Now, that's because of roadworks taking about half an hour, and it's been like that for most of the day. The A85 at the Dalconzi turn, an accident is blocking the road now, and that's between Comrie and Lough Erne Head. Cheshire queues on the M62 have eased on the westbound side, 11 at Birchwood to 10. That was near the Croft interchange, the M6 at junction 21A. There was an accident a while ago. Staffordshire queue still there with the A53, which is closed in both directions. That's from Leek, it's north of Leek, heading towards Blackshaw Moor. Also queues in Bristol, now it's very slow on the M4 on the westbound side. That's from junction 19 at the M32 at Bristol through to the M5 at the Almondsbury interchange at junction 20. It's a breakdown in one of the lanes. Lincolnshire, the A15, both directions, and that's an accident which has closed the road near Welton Cliff. The A17 19 in Nottinghamshire. Both directions closed at Coddington near Sleaford Lane. That was an earlier accident which cleared. And the